one another, die for each other, we're cool for the summer. So, what's up, guys? So, for this week, you know, there are times when you kind of look for news stories and you can't really find any. And then, near the end of the week, Benjamin Netanyahu opened his fucking mouth and basically began blaming Palestinians for the Holocaust. Yeah. And this isn't taken out of context. This isn't any sort of, you know, conspiracy theory or somehow something that could have just been, you know, somehow misinterpreted or misappropriated or misrepresented. He actually said that. There's also a description, a video in the description that links you to Maoist Rebel News, and that will actually give you the video and as well as Jason's interpretation of it. This was actually something that Netanyahu said. He literally makes the argument that because the assumption that Hitler just wanted to expel the Jews from Germany, and that Palestine didn't want to have, you know, or the Arabs, the Palestinian Arabs, didn't want to have the Jews in that neck of the woods, and so by doing so, Hitler asked, well, what do you want me to do? And Netanyahu's claim is that the Palestinian Arabs, Arab leader at the time, basically said, you know, had made the assumption to essentially get rid of them. You know, find another alternative. And of course, we know that what that was. But essentially, this is all, based on contradiction, baseless assumption, and just outright lies. Because first of all, by basically saying that the Palestinians did this, at the time there was no technical state of Palestine. It was, there was no Israel-Palestine. It was actually one British protectorate. So, at the time, it was one of those things where it wasn't necessarily there wasn't really a Palestinian Arab or a Palestinian Israeli Jewish sort of thing. So essentially, it's the fact also, and also given the fact that, you know, technically Israel doesn't recognize the state of Palestine, doesn't actually acknowledge an actual Palestinian state. So it's all based upon this contradiction of that. So he inadvertently acknowledged the state of Palestine, all while basically trying to make up lies about it to further his Zionist and anti-Islamic and plainly, nationalistic and far-right tendencies. He's using this lie as a basis for his genocidal reign of terror, for Israel's genocidal reign of terror. And basically making the assertion that Hitler did not want to, did not have some sort of grand scheme to get rid of the Jewish population by exterminating them, which is bullshit. Hitler had a plan from the get-go, had scientists and researchers trying to come up with bigger and just more homicidal ways of killing people, more effective ways of killing people, and ways that he could speed up the process of killing people. And obviously not just using this against the Jewish population, using this also against communists, labor unionists, trade unionists, you know, using it against other political opponents, using it against gypsies, using it against homosexuals, using it against, you know, essentially anybody he did not view as Aryan. And by saying that, by basically trying to say that all Hitler wanted to do was expel the Jews and that it, for somehow it's all the Palestinians' fault, is an outright lie and outlandish claim. When Hitler blatantly wanted to kill Jews from the get-go, it's written in his very own manifesto. It is clear as daylight that his anti-Semitism and his ultra-nationalistic beliefs led him to his plan of wanting to murder Jews from the get-go. But of course, no, it's all the Palestinians' fault because oh, we don't like the Palestinians, so let's try to manipulate and twist history and historical facts around so that it looks like the Palestinians had something to do with the Nazi regime, that somehow the Palestinians influenced the Nazi regime, which is horseshit. And yes, I'm not taking away from the fact that there are certain connections with the Saddamist Ba'ath Party in Iraq. That, you know, it is one of those things that there are connections between the Ba'athists and Nazism. That much is true. And essentially some forms of Arab nationalism were sympathetic towards the Nazis. That does not take away from the fact, though, that, you know, Palestine had, that still doesn't prove that Palestine had anything to do with the Nazi regime. To claim that Palestinians, or that all, you know, all Arabs, and, you know, all Arab nationalists, and all, you know, all Arabs and all Muslims somehow are these genocidal maniacs that go out and want to kill everybody, that somehow they contributed to the Nazi regime, is almost as fucking idiotic as people claiming that all Muslims are it's basically equating it to the same thing of all Muslims are terrorists, all Arabs are terrorists, all terrorists are Arab and Muslim, which is a bunch of crap, because we know that isn't true. You know, it's this blatant Islamophobia that we keep seeing, predominantly in the West and in a fascist state such as Israel. You know, it has literally gotten to this point where Israel's growing fascist government, let me rephrase that, Israel's fascist government is literally manipulating facts and making up slanderous accusations and lies to justify their brutal, genocidal, regime of ethnic cleansing. You know, which I find ironic, because they're using, you know, they're using this fear of, this old fear of Nazism to justify their, well, frankly, what I would call neo-Nazi beliefs. Because that is exactly what they are doing. They are doing the exact same things the Nazis are doing, just on a different scale, just on a slightly tweaked version of it. It's still ethnic cleansing. It's still human genocide. It's still apartheid. But yet, apparently, somehow, what they're doing is justified because all Arabs and all Muslims and all Palestinians are just these evil Nazi terrorists that have to be stopped. It's a bunch of crap. It's a bunch of Islamophobic BS. And I'm really, really getting sick and tired of it. You know, and then let's not even, you know, I won't even go into it, but I will mention it. The fact that, you know, certain Israeli citizens that happen to be, you know, sympathetic towards a peaceful solution, a cohabitation of Israelis and Palestinians, you know, this whole, the one state, you know, or what I would just call in general the solutionists, the people that actually have sympathy and want this brutal reign of terror stopped. You know, the people that, much like the Jewish people that were marching in New York City and other places, saying stop the genocide, free Palestine. Yeah, there were people in Israel doing that too. In fact, there were probably as many grand marches against the Israeli government in Israel, in Tel Aviv, in Jerusalem, than there were in the U.S. and London and other places. But you know what's happening also in Israel? Those very people are suddenly disappearing. Those people are, you know, suddenly coming up dead. I wonder why that is. I wonder why, you know, an Israeli citizen who opposes their government, opposes their genocidal, ethnic cleansing, fascist regime against a group, another group of human people, of human civilization. I just wonder why, you know, they would be showing up dead, you know, or disappearing, you know, mysteriously. Maybe it has something to do with the fact that the government of Israel, Netanyahu's fascist fucking regime, doesn't want these people spreading that message. They don't want them to have a peaceful solution. They don't want the genocide to stop. That they want to continue doing what they want to do, and not what their people want them to do. You know, I kind of find it funny how politically the U.S. is so divided, but in Israel, they're just as divided over the issue of Palestine. And the opposition towards the people that are opposed to the genocide, to the killing on both sides of the spectrum, the people that are opposed to the Israeli government, are just being picked off. You know, it's one of those things that does bring to mind some interesting thoughts about, you know, some really scary comparisons to the Nazi regime, or even to, even more recently, the South African regime. It's really quite scary when you think about that even Israeli citizens who sympathize with the Palestinian cause, who basically find that, even oppose their government and say that the genocide, the killing, the wars are wrong, and even have spoken out and said that Israel has been the ones that have often fired first, are suddenly either mysteriously disappear, they're killed, or they're labeled as being crazy conspiracy theorists, or even traitors. Yeah, it's actually one of those things where in the state of Israel, being an Israeli citizen, speaking out against the government, is practically considered treason. To have any sort of sympathy or opposition to what Israel's doing to the Palestinian people is considered treason. You know, again, that just speaks. It does draw scary parallels to the Nazi regime. Because what did the Nazis do? Anybody that was sympathetic towards the Jews, sympathetic towards the communists, sympathetic towards gay people, that or simply just spoke out and said what Germany was doing was wrong, they were considered traitors. That if they didn't do their duty, they would be killed, or at very least removed from their positions. If they were a government official, usually removed from their positions, but killings were common. Disappearances were common. And being labeled as a traitor? And it's the same exact sort of thing. It's the same nationalistic BS. That traitor is almost a term that is supposed to be meant to break the will and the spirit of that citizen, because they're basically, by being labeled a traitor, they're literally having their identity, their nationality, their very being stripped from them. because the state simply said, well, if you are not with us, you are against us, and if you are against us, you are a traitor. So simply put, if you don't like what we're doing, and you don't want to do our bidding, then you are going to be considered a traitor. And in most cases, and you know, and this is really what I truly believe, those people are killed. Israeli citizens are being killed as well. It's not just Palestinians. It's Israeli people too. In fact, I would even make a very broad claim to say that I think even more Israeli citizens are killed by their own government, if at least as many, by their own government, than Palestinians. It's a really sad state of affairs. But to literally go out and make a bold-faced lie and claim that all Israel is united somehow against this great Palestinian, this great Arab threat, is absolutely ridiculous. Because no, not all of Israel is. In fact, a good chunk of people actually do oppose their government's brutal reign of terror. And many Jews around the world are opposed to Israel's genocidal reign of terror. And to go out and make bold-faced lies saying that the Palestinians are somehow responsible for this, you know, inadvertently admitting, first of all, that there is a Palestinian state, which Israel technically doesn't do, you know, that hypocrisy, but literally to make claims that somehow make this assumption that all Palestinians are just these evil people. It's ridiculous. I'm appalled. And then if that's not bad enough, we've reached a peak what the fuck moment when we look at the fact that there are two neo-Nazi, or let me rephrase that, two Nazbol parties, National Bolshevik parties, neo-Nazi Nazbol fucking parties in Israel. And the only reason that they split from one another was over their issue about Pol Pot. Like, the fuck? Like, really? Like, the fuck? You fucking are opposed to... You have a difference over Pol Pot, and yet you're advocating that's your biggest problem, but yet you advocate almost the exact same things, the genocidal reign of terror, of anti-Semitism, of anti-communism, and all this other BS that fascists make up. Yeah, it really does say a lot, though, doesn't it, about the state that Israel finds itself in? I mean, can we really be surprised that they have Nazbol parties and that they have neo-Nazi parties when they themselves are their own government is literally a fascist regime? Even the Jewish Homeland Party or whatever that was gaining pretty high steam over the last few years and was gaining seats in the Knesset. You know, have we... That party not only believes in this Jewish fundamentalism and this ultra-Jewish nationalism, i.e. Zionism, and literally believes in petty authoritarianism and further militarism, that they literally have no qualms about the killing of Palestinians. Basically, have even said calling them essentially what Hitler called the Jews. They're calling the Jewish Homeland Party has literally gone to the great lengths to equate them to being vermin. And, you know, have basically, and even members of these parties going out and saying that the fetuses from the Palestinian mothers should be basically should be cut from their wombs. So they're literally egging on not just even mass genocide. They're talking about plain. They've gone to almost full lengths of eugenics. And this is the same shit over and over, whether it be the Zionist Union, whether it be Netanyahu's fucking party. It doesn't matter. The ultra-conservatism, the ultra-nationalism, the Islamophobia, the anti-Arab sentiment is strong within the political system, at least within the government. It does not necessarily mean that all of Israelis think this way, and thankfully we actually have signs and, you know, this really breath of fresh air that not all of them are, thank the fucking gods. But there's still this strong resentment, the strong fucking fascist elements that still exist. And we can see that. We've all known for a while, us Marxists in the both the First and Third World have seen and known that Netanyahu was a fucking terrorist, that he's a fucking fascist, that he himself idolizes a ultranationalist and frankly neo-Nazi sort of sentiment, an almost Nazbol sentiment. But now it's just it doesn't even seem like these ultra-right Israeli politicians, doesn't even seem like they're even trying to hide it anymore. It just seems like they're being blatantly open with it. And of course the West sits by and does nothing, because the West has interests in Israel, and the West, being Christian Judeo, has strong ties with this country. I mean, even ultra-rightists in the fucking Republican Party within the American political system actively support Netanyahu, and literally have even gone to their own measures to try to state that anybody who calls the Israeli government and Netanyahu and these people fascists or Nazis, or compares them to these entities, that even so much as speaks out against them, is they're trying to label as terrorists. That they're trying to basically take down their YouTube channels, flag them, and take down and go after them. And that's not a fascist sort of element? Is that not a decaying sense of order, a decaying sense of civility? You know, Lenin definitely said it right when he said fascism is capitalism in decay. Seems like ever since the global collapse in 2008, we've been seeing more and more racist, more anti-Islamic or Islamophobia sort of sentiment go out there. We've seen more blatant attacks on immigrants, on refugees. Where does it end? The Western world is turning to fascism. So is it any surprise that these fascist elements are supporting a fascist entity? I don't see the surprise in that. In fact, I'm really not surprised at all. I've seen this coming. Many of us in the Marxist community have seen this coming. And those that even activists that have been opposed to the Netanyahu regime, that have been opposed to Zionism, that have been opposed to the Islamophobia, within and abroad from Israel, we've seen this coming, but the world does nothing. I've also said in the past that, and still openly say it, the Israeli people and the Palestinian people, for that matter, need to rise above their governments, overthrow this brutal reign of terror on both sides, but predominantly within the Israeli government. They need to overthrow this threat. They need to literally nip it in the bud while they still can. Because with the way things are currently in Israel, with the crackdowns and the overwhelming police state that it really is becoming, the apartheid regime that exists, if something isn't done soon, it may be too late. Israel is in worse condition than any Western power. They're in worse condition than Greece with their economic issues. And the people don't even realize that. I don't even think the Palestinian victims of the Israeli genocide, I don't even think they understand just how dark things really are. I'm just at a loss of words, though, that Netanyahu literally has the sack, doesn't even have a care in the world anymore, that he just now opens his mouth and just lets it run, much like Hitler did whenever he spoke. Israeli politicians don't even think anymore. They don't even fucking care anymore. They don't have a filter. They don't even try to hide anything anymore. They just blatantly go out and say it. And I find it interesting how they try to play the victim card about, we were persecuted for 2,000 years by different societies and blah blah blah. Yes, you were, and I'm not taking away from that. But I find it funny that they can play the victim card so well. The Israeli government can play the victim card so damn well, even while their own people scream for them to stop. And in doing so, what do? They turn around and kill their own people. The people in other countries, Jewish people in other countries, who stand up and say, "Free Palestine, stop the genocide, stop the killing, stop the hatred." And yet, these people are somehow labeled as some sort of threat. Why? Because they've taken a stance against, what they consider to be morally wrong, which it is, and against the Geneva Convention. I just find it really, I find it interesting how this tide of fascism has basically turned the element of anti-Semitism, and not saying that anti-Semitic feelings don't exist within within fascist groups, especially within the Golden Dawn Party or any other white supremacist group. But it's funny how this tide of fascism has turned towards different, it has basically turned towards an element of neo-fascism, and these new and it, more dark and sinister elements, where it's okay to be, you know, pan-Slavic and proud to be a Slav and all these issues, but have problems with immigrants and different things. I mean, these things that we see in Eastern Europe specifically, like the rise in neo-Nazism and Nazbolism in Ukraine and Poland and Hungary and the Czech Republic and Slovakia, in what's another one? I think that might be it. But yeah, this ride of neo-Nazism and Nazbolism, and this rise in neo-Nazism that we see in Greece, which again, ironic considering what Nazis did to the Greeks, but literally how there's this tide there, and how there's even this nationalistic sentiment even in Israel, and this neo-Nazism in Israel, and this Nazbolism in Israel, which again, ironic, but again, this tide of neo-fascism comes with new ideas of hate. And a lot of those new ideas of hate have turned away from the idea of anti-Semitism and more towards anti-Islam, more towards Islamophobia, more towards anti-immigration and anti-Islam, should I say. Now, the main focus has been on immigration and Islam these days, and how this has perpetrated this growing tide of neo-fascism. I find it incredible, and at the same time, increasingly just scary. I can't even think of another word other than that. It really is one of these things that we have seen this growing the old tides of neo-Nazism and stuff like that turn towards this growing trend of neo-fascism. In fact, it's gotten to the point where neo-Nazism itself is more of a threat to in the Western world, but in areas like Eastern Europe, in Russia, in Israel, and even within the Middle East itself, there's this growing tide of neo-fascism. And even in Japan, this growing tide of neo-fascism. And I don't know what to say. I really don't know what to say. I just think, I just really think that the whole idea that people have begun turning so much towards this extremist right wingism is appalling, it's frightening, and it's just absolutely ridiculous. It's so fucking stupid. And of course, the people out there that, you know, want to scream, well, they're coming in from all the, you know, why should we take in these 10,000 immigrants? Why should we cater to all these immigrants and blah, 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 you know, my country. And it's absolutely fucking retarded. You know. And I just I don't know. I really don't have much more to say. I think I've really run out of things to say, because without trying to repeat myself, at least not as, you know, at least not as many times, there's not much left I could really say to this issue. Other than as I basically explained earlier, the West is turning to fascism. And really, it's not surprising, because we've seen this. We've seen this growing tide of, you know, white supremacist violence that has been occurring within the United States. You know, whether it be Charleston, whether it be Lafayette, you know, whether it be the Sikh temple shooting in Wisconsin a couple of years ago. You know, and whether it just be some crazy idiot with a shooting up schools. You know, there's been, and even with that, we're still learning more about these different idiots, specifically the one up in Oregon. But yes, there's been this growing trend of white supremacist and neo-fascist violence. Hell, the crisis in Ukraine, caused because a bunch of neo-fascist thugs overthrew the government in Kiev and now have their panties in a twist because they're fighting the communists. Gee, I wonder why, because communists don't want to submit to your fucking rule? No shit, Sherlock. The growing tide of this national, ultra-nationalist, neo-Nazi Nazbol, neo-fascist violence that you see in Poland, and again in other parts of Eastern Europe. Anders Breivik, who shot up those young socialists in Sweden a few years ago. There's even been a rising trend of neo-Nazism in Germany again, and the rising Front National in France, who could actually legitimately gain power eventually. And then and neo-fascists in fucking Italy, and the Golden Dawn assholes down in friggin' Greece. The friggin' right-wing extremist groups in Japan that are growing. The increasingly number of anti-communist and just ultra-conservative, ultra-nationalistic dunces that run South Korea. You know, the same people that shut down the United Progressive Party back in December last year because, oh, that they were too sympathetic to North Korea. They were fucking petty bourgeois liberals who believed in reunification. They weren't somehow sympathetic to the fucking North Koreans. Stupid fucking idiots. And of course, the fascist dictatorship of Park Geun-hye. She's just like her fucking father. She really is. And the ultra-conservatism that exists in the Philippines, and their proposed crackdown, for, you know, a hardline crackdown on the Communist Party of the Philippines and the New People's Army and the people down there. And now, of course, this bullshit in Israel. Well, not even just now, not now, this bullshit in Israel. This bullshit in Israel has been going on for a long time. It's just basically rearing its very ugly head now. But that fucking sentiment was there from the beginning. So yeah, I'm done. I'm just at this point letting off what steam I have about it. It just blows me away that we actually have that we live in this society where this fascism and this this hatred of people, this nationalism, is turning towards Arabs instead, from where it used to be. And where this fascist government in Israel is allowed to commit genocidal reigns of terror against another another group of human population. Where, and how the rest of us, how those of us that actually stand up against this tide of fascism, whether it be Nazbols, whether it be neo-Nazis, whether it be white supremacists, whether it be para-fascists and neo-fascists, or Zionists, or whoever the fuck it is, those of us that even stand up against it are basically labeled as the terrorists, as the enemies. And I'm fucking sick of it. So, yeah. And once again, let me just clarify something. There is a difference between being anti-Zionist and anti-Semitic. An anti-Zionist is a person that opposes Jewish nationalism and this belief in ultra-nationalism, that Israel somehow has a divine right to rule over that particular area and essentially colonize and ethnically cleanse and kill masses of people without like they have some sort of right to do that, despite that they are in violation of several international laws and including the Geneva Convention. We're an anti-Semitism, but anti-Semitism is this idea that you just hate Jewish people. But there's a vast difference. Anti-Semites are a bunch of fascist retards like Golden Dawn. Anti-Zionists are people that oppose imperialism, they oppose militarism, they oppose nationalist sentiment, such as the one that the Israeli government holds. But they're against the killing of an entire group of people. That is the main difference. Because that itself, that killing, that militarism, that imperialism, that colonialism, that nationalism, that's fascism. People that are anti-Zionism is essentially a fascist ideology. And being anti-Zionist is being anti-fascist. That's the point I make. Whereas an anti-Semite is fascist. And the two could... the two of those ideologies are vastly different. That's the one thing I wanted to point across before I ended this video. So, with all that said, I'm NorCal Nick, leader of the revolutionist movement, and this has been NorCal.